Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom. Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom.
In his agony, as he hangs on the tree, Jesus has two companions, the thieves who are crucified on either side of him. In their response to him, they represent the whole of humanity. One, rejecting and dismissive, cursing and contemptuous. The other, turning in penitence and faith, recognizing his Saviour and the injustice of the punishment. While he lived, Jesus provoked those two responses. And even in his death, they continue.
One of the criminals who were hanged there kept deriding him and saying, "Are you not the Messiah? Save yourself and us." But the other rebuked him, saying, "Do you not fear God, since you are under the same sentence of condemnation? And we indeed have been condemned justly, for we are getting what we deserve for our deeds. But this man has done nothing wrong." Then he said, "Jesus, remember me when you come into your kingdom." He replied, "Truly I tell you, today you will be with me in paradise."
Even in his dying, Jesus had compassion for others. Even in his agony, he was prepared to offer comfort to a penitent thief. Even as he drew his last breath, he spent his breath in giving reassurance to someone who came to him in repentance. We light a candle to represent the light of the world, which the darkness cannot extinguish.
We adore you, O Christ, and we praise you, because by your holy cross you have redeemed the world.
Today there are those who reject Jesus and those who turn to him. Today there are those who seek to avoid their rightful punishment and those who accept it as their just deserts. As Jesus opened his heart to the penitent thief, there are those today who need to hear words of forgiveness and acceptance.
We light a candle to represent our prayers for those who are haunted by their fears and need to hear words of reassurance and love.
Perhaps there are times when we too need to hear words of forgiveness and acceptance. Can we, like the thief, ask Jesus for pardon and reassurance? Can we have faith to believe that we will indeed be with him in paradise? Can we take to him our deepest needs? We light a candle to represent our prayers for ourselves.
Let us pray. Lord Jesus, even in your deepest agony, you listened to the crucified thief. Hear us as we unburden to you our deepest fears. You spoke words of love in your hour of death. Help us to speak words of life to a dying world. To you, Jesus, who offer hope to the hopeless, be honour and glory with the Father and the Holy Spirit, now and forever. Amen.
Glory be to God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, world without end. Amen.
How deep the Father's love for us, how vast beyond all measure, that He should give His only Son to make a wretch His treasure. How great the pain of searing loss, the Father turns His face away, as wounds which mar the chosen one bring many sons to glory.